If you're looking to grow your YouTube channel and get more subscribers, but are struggling to break through the plateau, I'm going to share with you 5 things that I did in order to 20x my YouTube channel over the last year. Last year, my channel was really struggling to grow and I was only growing at about 100 subscribers a month. And now this year, I'm growing at about 24 to 2500 subscribers every single month. And all that I did was focus on the 5 things that I'm going to talk about in this video. So if you're ready to take it up a notch, if you're ready to commit to building a business on YouTube and using it to scale your brand, impact, influence, and income, don't skip a beat in this video because I'm going to explain exactly how I've done just that. What's up, guys? It's Mike Sherrard. Thanks so much for tuning in. As always, we're sitting here on a beautiful day in YYC or Calgary, as you can see behind me. And YouTube has done a lot for my business over this year. It's helped me scale my online programs. It's helped me build my brand. It's helped me attract a lot of people to my team. And it's been really exciting to see what YouTube can truly do for your business if you invest in it and go about it the right way. But a lot of people really struggle to grow their YouTube channel. So let's dive into how you can do it and how I've gone from, 500 subscribers last year to, at the end of this year, I'll hit well over 20,000 and continuing to grow. So the first thing that you really need to understand, and the biggest thing that made an impact for me, is understanding how to properly optimize your content. A lot of people are putting out great content, but they're wondering why it's not getting found, why it's not getting any views, and why it's not getting any engagement. And the problem is, and this is just the reality of the YouTube algorithm or any social media platform for that matter, is that you could have the best content on the world. I've worked with production companies that have, $20,000 videos, but nobody's watching it. If you do not have your content optimized properly for YouTube, you're not gonna get any traction. If you wanna see the key components of the YouTube algorithm, click above where you'll see my YouTube video, which is actually one of the top ranking videos on YouTube about how to understand the YouTube algorithm. Tags, titles, descriptions, thumbnails, and then adhering to YouTube algorithm's criteria of post-launch velocity, click-through rate, and watch time. You really have to understand how to cater your content specifically to what the algorithm wants to make sure that when you're putting out a new piece of content, it's got a pretty good chance of ranking highly whenever people are searching for that type of video. This year, I went all in on making sure that every single time I put out a video, it was properly optimized to rank for that category. And that's made a world of a difference for my content. Instead of getting 100 views, it's getting thousands of views. And now it's really starting to help my channel grow. So if you're going to commit to YouTube, make sure that if you're going to invest the time, energy, attention, and money into growing your channel, you actually do the exact same with making sure that the content's optimized to even have an opportunity to scale after you've published it. Now, number 2 has been consistency. This is where a lot of people go wrong, is understanding the fact that if you're going to commit to your channel being a big component of your business or just committing to it in any capacity, you have to have some level of consistency. If you post 3 times this week, none the week after, 1 week after that, and then 5 videos, it's not going to give your audience the opportunity to understand why and when they should be following your content. Just look at any TV show that you like, for example, or maybe a Netflix series. If you're watching Game of Thrones, for example, and suddenly they put out 2 videos this week, 1 video the week after, 1 new episode the week after that, 0 episodes for 5 months, you're probably not going to have a good time following that show, and it's going to be difficult for you to follow along and stay very engaged on that show. Very similar to your YouTube channel. Look at anybody that you follow on YouTube. If somebody that you follow has committed to daily videos for the last year and suddenly they skip the next 2 months, you're gonna wonder what's going on. I know that for all of my favorite channels, that they've got a very specific posting regime and you expect content from them on specific days. And if they don't, you kind of feel like your entertainment has gotten lost. The same thing goes for your channel. You need to make sure that you can commit to a very strict posting schedule so that you train your audience as to when to expect new videos coming from you and to know that you're actually going to consistently being delivered, whether it be entertainment or education. Number 3 is quality. Making sure that the quality of your content, not just in terms of the audio, not just in terms of the video, but in terms of the quality of what you're delivering to your audience. My channel is less about entertainment and more about education. So if I start putting out videos that doesn't really have anything that people can watch the video on and then take away and implement, people might start unsubscribing to your channel. If you're an entertainer and some of your videos start being really dull, people might not follow you for as long. So what I really started diving deep into this year is making sure that I pour into my audience. I give as much value as I humanly can on my videos. I try and make sure that every single video people watch of mine, they can leave that video, take action on something that's actually going to make a difference in their business. And that's the feedback that I've gotten this year, is that people have been able to watch my content, scale their business to the six-figure level in my niche. And that's been allowing people to find my channel and continue to subscribe. So make sure that you do provide high quality in terms of the production, but also make sure that you dive deep into the quality of the value that people are getting from your content, whether it be on an educational or an entertainment level. Number four is a really interesting one, and I wasn't expecting this, but it really has shown true, is repurposing my content and cross-promoting on different platforms. So last year I was just posting content on my YouTube channel, get 50 to 100, maybe 200 views on a good day, and that's all that I was doing, is posting on there, hoping for the best. But now what I've been able to do is cross-promote it using content repurposing. My company actually does this for a lot of elite-level entrepreneurs, even newer entrepreneurs. If you want to know more about those services, which basically is automated the Gary V method, comment below and I'll gladly send you our service list on that. But what I've been able to do is take my long-form YouTube videos, repurpose them shorter form for Instagram. But if I'm delivering message, maybe the three key tips to the YouTube algorithm, I would post maybe the first key tip on my Instagram, and then people have to watch my YouTube video to see the rest of the tips. So that way I'm getting a good Instagram post out of it. I'm driving traffic to the YouTube video, and that in order to see the remainder of the value that they came for, they have to watch the full video. And that's really helped me, because I in turn shared on Facebook and LinkedIn and a swipe up on my Instagram story. So people are seeing and getting traffic driven to it from multiple sources. But the biggest one has been able to leverage the power of an email list. Listen guys, if you're diving deep into creating a YouTube channel, you have to create an email list that you own, and you have to be able to keep your audience up to date with your latest and greatest videos. And that's going to be a great way to increase your post launch velocity, increase your engagement, and increase the subscribers on your channel. So make sure that if you don't have an email list right now for your channel, that you create one, you get a CRM, you do some sort of thing like ActiveCampaign or MailChimp, and you start to leverage and build an email list that will help you grow your channel. And number five is sticking to your niche. A lot of people put out content that's kind of all over the place. They know, they say, okay, Mike, you know, I'm an entrepreneur. I know how to do real estate. I know how to do social media. I know how to coach. I know how to mentor. I know how to sell clothes. I know e-commerce. I know drop shipping. I know Amazon FBA. I know it all. And they start putting out content about all of that. The problem is that if you don't niche down your content, people aren't going to stay as subscribers. You have to understand, guys, let's look at your, you know, favorite entrepreneur, for example. If you're following an entrepreneur that's in the real estate investing space, and they start posting about drop shipping, and then the next video is about Amazon FBA, and the next video is about how to start a clothing line, and the next video is about Bitcoin, and the next video is about this, that, and the other thing. If you subscribe to that channel for real estate investing content, and then the next seven videos have nothing to do with it, you're gonna wonder, why am I subscribed to this channel? When am I gonna get the next piece of content that actually is gonna benefit me, which is why I subscribed to it in the first place? You need to make sure you're catering your content to a specific niche target audience. And I made the mistake last year where I was trying to do a bit of content for local real estate content, and then real estate investing, and then I was doing a bit over here and a bit over there, and ultimately, I started diluting the quality of the content I was delivering to my target audience. So what I did is I honed it in, focused on my niche, and that's when things really started to scale. So make sure you have a very clear understanding of what type of audience you're trying to go after, and catering your content specifically to those people, so that they know that every time you release a video, they're gonna get something valuable that they like, comment, subscribe on, like hopefully you're gonna do on this video for me, and that's gonna help grow your channel. So if you have any other questions about growing your YouTube channel and getting more subscribers, just drop a comment below. I do respond to 100% of people personally that comment on my videos, because I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart, and the engagement means the world to me. So hopefully this gives you an idea of how I've been able to scale my channel and helps you do the same. So thanks so much for tuning in. As always, please make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and we will see you next time.